Hi everyone and welcome to the third challenge video that I did with CraftyGen. If you have not seen the first and the second video yet, you really should head over and check them out. I will link them here in this video. And you should also check out CraftyGen's channel just to see what she created. It really went awesome and it was a super, super fun project to do with her. She's an awesome person, she does awesome artwork, so please, please get over and check her channel out as well. And of course, subscribe to her. And if you're new to my channel and have not subscribed yet, I would really appreciate if you did subscribe to mine as well. So let's come back to this project here. This is the third in a row, and this one is again an abstract one, themed around the topic of ocean again. In our planning phase, a couple of weeks back, we decided that the third abstract painting should contain the letters and words make everyday count onto it. It really was a challenge for me. I really had to think about the concept how I wanted to look, and I came up with a great idea, which I thought, and I started it. And on the go I decided that although the painting is really pretty that I started, and you have not seen yet, I lost the track where I want to write something on there, that it looks genuine and fitting to the piece and not ruining the piece as a whole. So I was really happy with the result on the go, but then decided that I need to go another approach where the words fit better and not seem just like making a beautiful painting and writing onto it. So this one is going to come in a future video as well, but just as a plain beautiful painting, not with something written onto it. So I had to start over making up another idea for this abstract one, and this video here is about the third approach that I took to make it happen. You see me here at my parents' house, so the setup is a bit different background-wise than usual, but you might not even notice. We have the summer of our life here. It is super, super hot outside. We're expecting temperatures about 38-ish degrees Celsius. It's really, really hot. And so I made this outside on our terrace. You see here a 30 by 60 centimeter canvas, which I just painted in solid metallic colors. And the colors that I'm using you can see actually on this frame here as well. It is a hellblau, a silver and hellgold. And I'm pretty sure your German skills are as advanced to see that it's a light blue, a silver and a light gold. So this is actually what I used for the background. And when I did the background, it already looked kind of beautiful. So I could have hung it like it was. I decided for the metallics just to have a very shiny background when the end result is finished. And so basically I just grabbed my acrylics and made a somewhat water to sand transition. So which is pretty easy to do. So just grab your paints, paint it on your canvas and blend it with a bit of water, or just blend it as long as it's wet. So this one was really easy. It went pretty quickly as well. I had to let it dry. But as it was burning hot outside, it basically dried immediately. So and when this one was dry, it was time to add the design that I made. So make everyday count was set already, so this was the words that I wanted to use or that I had to use. And CraftyGen, I tell you what, I really can't wait to see what you came up with. So the general approach here for this one was when I saw CraftyGen's second video, which was the acrylic pour, and that she printed out the words on plastic and glued them onto there. Basically, I really like the concept and I want to try something like that here as well, but I don't have such a plastic cutter piece. So I just went for tape. I made a design that I wanted for this piece to look like, and it should be something abstract, as abstract was the goal, and somewhat difficult to read. So I want that everyone can read it if they look at it from quite a distance, but it should not be too obvious. So just to make it look more interesting perhaps. So I made up my design on a sheet of paper and tweaked it around a bit to make it look fitting together. You will see what I mean. And then I just taped everything on this painted surface. And this, I tell you, was really a time-consuming thing. It took me about an hour or so taping all the lines there, and I had to rearrange some of the lines on the go again because my drawing did not really fit to real life, and I had to alter some of the lines on the go to make everything work out as I wanted. It did not really work out perfectly as I intended on my sketch, but I hope every one of you will be able to read the words, so you know them already now. So it was really, really fun. And when everything was taped to the surface, I had just to paint it over. So you will know this setup here, because now we have my messy desk again. For the second coat, I basically opted for some darker colors. I wanted them to be different than the base layer colors, as I want to be able to see the words in the very end when I remove the tape. So I went a bit darker. I added some structure paste just to give it some more abstract structure in the very end, and some texture. This is just regular, yeah, it's a paste. You can apply it with a spatula or your palette knife, and then it's going to dry pretty hard. Yeah, it creates some texture when you paint over it. The rest is just acrylic paint, again blended into each other. And finally, I also added some of the metallic acrylics over these structure bumps that I had there, just to give it a more shiny variant, because shiny is great. And when the cover layer was dried, the really fun part began: peeling all this stuff off. It was a mess. It took quite a while to peel everything off. It ran pretty easy, so I expected the acrylic paint might stick too well together, and that the tape tears itself apart and rips and doesn't come off as great as I hoped to, but it really went pretty well. At some places you will see that I ruptured the underlayer, so it was a reused canvas, and so I just painted gesso over it, then I painted the base layer over it, and so I ripped the base layer and the gesso layer off, which I then had to correct afterwards again. But well, it was really not so much of a deal. I was pretty happy with the result, so I was able to read everything that I intended. I liked that the underlayer was lighter at most of the parts than the upper layer, and it was visible what I wanted to present there. I have also put it outside in the sun in the very end, just to give you an impression how shiny it is when the sun hits it. And yeah, that is basically my approach to this idea. Again, I really can't wait to see what Jen came up with. We did not show our results beforehand, so it was really a surprise for both of us for each project. You might have thought that we shared ideas or something on the go, but we did not. We wanted to give each of these ideas our own approach, with not interfering with the other one's idea. And it really turns out perfectly. So we always had some kind of different approaches for each of these paintings. And I'm really curious what Jen's result is looking like. This one, to be honest, was pretty much on the edge of my comfort zone. It was a challenging project, which was the intention behind it. And I really hope you liked the result. It was something really different, and I really like looking at it. So I really like it. And I'm also kind of proud of me. Yeah, as usual, please let me know in the comment section what you think of it, how you like the entire project series with Crafty Jen, and of course if you have subscribed to her. If not, you really should do, she's such a cutie. And for those of you who might be new to my channel and this might be the first video that you've seen of mine, please make sure to give me a thumbs up if you liked it. Also your others, please. And share it with everyone who might be interested in it. And of course, I would also be honored if you would subscribe to my channel to not miss out any of my new coming videos. I do have a ton of them already here. I think this is video 170-ish or so. So I basically have you covered with so many topics, and I hope you have a blast watching them. If you have whatsoever questions, please again leave me in the comment box below. I put all the material links as usual in the description box as well as my social media, Etsy store, whatever you need to get in contact with me. And yeah, I thank you so much for your time. Thank you for watching. And other than that, I wish you a great day. Bye bye.